Kashmir.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Mr. President, as I sat down to write this speech, there were many things going in my mind. For a moment, I thought to talk about the misconceptions known as Islamophobia. There could have been a heated debate over the ongoing economic crisis, poverty, defense, religion, health, etc. There were callings from my Syrian and Palestinian brothers. Mr. President, what else I could talk about except the ongoing situation in Kashmir? I could hear the terrible voices coming from Kashmir. I can feel the pain of the mother who has just lost his son in an open fire from an Indian Army soldier. I won't go in the historic background that what happened and how it happened and who allowed it to happen. Many of you know it quite well. I am going to tell you that what is happening in the world with the Muslim community. The people of Kashmir, Syria, Palestine, and Rohingya are taken to the cleaners. Do you know why? Because they are Muslims. The whole world is silent over these sort of issues because they are Muslims. Their blood is cheaper than the water. Do you know why? Because they are Muslims. I want to ask a question from the whole world. Are we the son of a lesser God? The valley of Kashmir, which was to be known for its charm and beauty, is bleeding every day. Every Kashmiri wakes up with a possible chance that it might be the last day of his life. Let me clear that Kashmir is not part of India and it will never be. Yarane jahan kehte hain Kashmir hai jannat. Yarane jahan kehte hain Kashmir hai jannat. Jannat kisi kafir ko mili hai na milegi. Mr. President, Kashmir is bleeding as long as I can remember. The people of Kashmir are sacrificing their lives, property, and peace of mind for about 70 years. Imagine the children coming back from the school and see that their homes are on fire. They will be the freedom fighters of tomorrow, and you will call them traitors. Pakistan has stood by Kashmir every minute and every second, and we will till their independence, inshallah. At the end, I want to warn the world. Look, Pakistan and India, both are nuclear powers, and if a conventional war starts between them, it will leave impacts beyond the borders. And what do you think we will do if we are left with one or two options, one to fight and second to surrender? My belief is La ilaha illallah, and we will fight. Thank you.